Watch us on YouTube and Facebook. Listen to our podcast and support us on Patreon. Thanks for stopping by.
Tales and theory and folklores were handed down from generations, from the Renaissance age until now, creating emotions and making feelings stir. Emotions hard to pinpoint, but there and unclear? Why do they affect people like they do? Are these emotions caused by particular disagreements with what has been handed down? We write and search for knowledge, finding amazing information that concerning our beliefs on many different levels. Information ignored about our history. The deeper we go and the more read, the crazier the stories get. Understanding has many levels that originate from reading and researching these stories and where they originate. Our understanding of things dramatically change. We hear terms like nation, great nations, and a new way of thinking. And I will make of thee a great nation, and I will bless thee, and make thy name great, and be thou a blessing. And I will bless thee unto them that, and he that curse thee will I curse, and in thee shall all the families of the earth be blessed. And ye shall be unto me the kingdom of priests, and a holy nation. These are the words which thou shalt speak unto words children of Israel. The Jewish people were once a holy nation, but they suffered greatly. In Christian beliefs it was because they had moved away from God, becoming more like the Gentiles as time passed. The term Goy was originally meant as a nation and other nations, but as time went by the same term was eventually used to signify the Gentiles in Jewish slang. 70 nations of Goy in the Old Testament, each with their language. The number of children of Shem, and the number of souls that went down into Egypt. Each candle on the menorah are represents of 10 nations, consisting of 7 candles. The battle raged on in the days of old, between the sun and moon, light and darkness. Battles between God and Satan, good and evil, men and the gods they worshipped. Some believed in one God, some believed in many, and wars raged on for lifetimes in their name. Asmodeus, demon of lust and king of the demons, held Jews hostage in fear. In battle, though the archangel Raphael chased Asmodeus into Egypt, where he bound him forever in the land of the pharaohs. Some Jews swayed from their beliefs, joining cults that worshipped other beliefs. Burial was sacred, but touching the dead with bare hands was considered an abomination. Kings stole lands and exiled people from where you lived. When kings died, exiled people would return to the lands that were native to them. A person's handicap caused frustration in marriages, causing many people to pray for death, because they were perceived as signs of disobedience towards their gods. Bird droppings could blind a man as he slept on the ground, and giant fish were able to attack a man's foot as it rested in the water. Men could be eaten entirely by beasts of the sea, then spit out without being harmed. Husbands could die because of a curse on the bride. Shameful fathers would hide these indiscretions by burying the groom's bodies at night. To go against the synagogue, for what a man's convictions were, was considered a sin, and great efforts had to be taken for people to be released from their curse. Heroes were born who overcame obstacles, using magical weapons, interpreted dreams, and could see into the future, and achieving victory at the end of the hero's adventure. Angels would disguise themselves and walk among us while magical incense was used to repel evil spirits and heal people of curses and ailments. Hearing these stories, they convey profound truths about the societies and cultures they originated from. Thought of as fanciful and false stories, but still a mark on history. Orientations and patterns of life revealing our priorities and prejudices, defining our imagination and how we deal with life. Relayed through symbol instead of systematic reason, and creating a relationship between ourselves and nature. Understanding comes on many levels, producing a change of mind, psychic change, spiritual experience, and moments of clarity. We hear terms and don't understand what they mean. Just as Abraham and his people build a nation for themselves, so have we. Once holy, and as time went by there were sufferings. Time and time again we move away from the gods we worship toward other things, and the past becomes the present once again. At first, nations, each with their language, with a history flowing from our ancestry, but as time went by terms within our language changed. Hopefully, we may someday save us from ourselves with our temples that display images of demons on their walls. Times of strife without answered prayers persist repeatedly, though pictures on the windows of cathedrals told stories of creation, and other religions outside of the Christian faith are considered false teachings. People died because of their beliefs, because they believed that the Christian God was actually the devil, and the devil is also the true God, while others believe that all religions should be combined into one. People also believe that we came from outer space, and some believe that nothing leads to nothing, free from religious dogma, but leading us nowhere. Protection for our love and good deeds in the name of a creator, or deeds done for creators who cared nothing for our love and welfare. Prostrating ourselves or bending down on our knees, while watching the world go to hell, and the protection never comes. Is this the true really for all of us, and if not, are there only a few that these protections include? If a book doesn't include a people, does it mean that those people don't have to follow the mandates of that book's rules? This is far from the truth, but the truth will be altered to accommodate for divine justice. Governments soon replace religion, and words like sovereignty, liberty are created with rule of law. To speak out against such things, people are scorned. Ignorance and disbelief allow our history to be distorted behind their lies, and denial that justifies its people's ways until it becomes hard for us to determine if people from the past ever existed at all. But hopefully a hero will appear, defeating the evils of the world, as it was foretold in the tales and folklore of the past. Maybe science will have all the answers we need. The seducer, destroyer, and evil of the world is in the mirror. Not at any time in our history has man ever achieved such standards as morality, and evil isn't of the divine, but from man himself. We are incomprehensible to our ancestors, based only on economics and science. Scientific study is censored, like religion was before it, and we no longer know what it is that we eat or drink. Politics run our life, and our heroes only perform in war, used only to fight. People are either cast out or killed for their transgressions, while others worship the architecture and geometry of beautiful skyscrapers, instead of cathedrals, temples, and pyramids. What is the cost of the individual, the price that he had to pay?
This was brought to you by The Strange, The Bizarre, The Unusual, I Like It, on YouTube and Facebook. Listen to our podcast on any of these platforms: Anchor, Breaker, Overcast, Pocket Casts, RadioPublic, Spotify. Support us on Patreon, and check us out on Discord. All the links can be found in the description below. We thank you for your participation. If you enjoyed, please like, subscribe, share, make comments. We love feedback.